गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माई स्टूडेंट, टेक आउट योर न्यू रेडियंट रीडर्स क्लास 8 बुक। टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर एंड द न्यू ओके द स्टोरी ऑफ पेपर 2। ऑल प्लांट मटेरियल यूज्ड इन द मेकिंग ऑफ पेपर कंटेन वेरी फाइन हेयर लाइक फाइबर्स। सो ऑल द प्लांट मटेरियल विच वॉज यूज इन मेकिंग पेपर कंटेन अ फाइन हेयर ओके like fibers. Fiber is called a thread which is formed from a vegetable tissue. It is the work of a paper maker to separate the fibers from the unwanted material. So it is the work of paper maker. Means the paper maker, person who makes paper, his work is to separate these fibers from the unwanted material. Unwanted means not desired material, and to press them together in a thin matted web which we know as a sheet of paper. So his job is to press them together in a thin matted. Matted means tangled into a thick mass. Web. Web is a network of fine thread which is constructed by a spider, which we know. As a sheet of paper. Formerly paper making was done entirely by hand, except for a few simple tools. Earlier paper making was done by the hand. Okay. Only a few tools was using. Racks were soaked and then pounded in to a fine pulp with a heavy hammers. So racks were soaked. Racks means a piece of old cloth that was soaked. Means they were it was extremely wet and then pounded to a fine pulp. Pounded means strike heavily and repeatedly to a fine pulp. Pulp, you know, a soft weight which is shapeless mass of material with heavy hammers. Okay. A thin layer of watery pulp is picked up on a very fine sieve. Means a thin layer of watery pulp. Means which is resembling of water pulp. Thin layer of it was picking up as a very fine sieve. Sieve is a utensil which is consisting of wire mesh, which is held in frame. And when a sheet was formed, after that the sheet is formed and it is pressed firmly and it is pressed little possibility of moving, that is called firmly. Means it is strongly it is pressed and allowed to dry. After that this is dried and it is finally polished. They are polishing also by rubbing, they are doing polish. All the paper for some purposes is still made by hand. Most of the paper for newspaper, books, magazines is now made by machines. So paper for special purpose, still the paper is made by hand, but most of the paper that we are using, like newspaper which we are reading, books, okay, paper which is used, magazines which, okay, still these papers are made by machines. Many of the machines are very complicated, and still we shall find it an interesting to pay a short visit to a paper mill and watch paper maker of today at work. So today many machines are very complicated. This it is very difficult to understand many machines. We can't understand many machines. It is very difficult, and still we find it an interesting. So we can find if we give a short visit. If we visit a paper mill, okay, we will able to watch how the paper maker work in a paper mill. The mill lies not in a city but in quite in a valley through which flows a rippling stream. So the paper mill is lying where? Okay. It is lying means it is in a specified state. It is not lying in a city, but in a valley it is lying. Okay, valley, we know, a low area of land which is lying between hills or mountains, through which flows a rippling stream. And through which a rippling stream flows. Rippling means a forming with a series of small waves on a surface, and stream means a small narrow river. Upon these streams the mill depends for its working. So upon these streams the mill's working is dependent. For paper making require a plentiful supply of good water. So paper mill require plentiful means it require a great quantity of supply of good water. In days gone by too, the streams was used to supply power. So the steam was used, okay, to supply water. It was used to supply power. Okay, it was supplying power. So to drive the mill. Okay, means driving means to blow with great force. Okay, but today tall chimneys, humming electrical machineries and stunting trains show that water power is no longer needed as a driving force. So today we can see the tall chimneys, okay, pipes we can see from which smoke is coming, that is called chimney. And humming is a normal vibration which is occur from the electrical appliance, electrical machinery. And shunting trains, shunting means push or pull from the main line to a siding, from one line of rails to another, that is called shunting. So that water power is no longer needed to as a driving force. So water power is no longer used so as to drive a force. Near the entrance of the mill is a large soft stack with dry dusty bales of spato grass. So near the entrance means an opening as a door that allows the access to the people. That is, from this entrance the people entering to the mill is a large loft stack with dry dusty. So it is a loft stack and dry. Loft means a room which is directly under the roof of a house which is used for storage. Okay, with dry dusty bales, and it is dry also and it is full of dust also. And bales is called a large bundles. Spato grass. Spato grass is a coarse grass which is having a tough and narrow leaves, which at first sight look like a hair, and at first it is looking like a hay. Hay means a grass that has been mown and dried and it is used as a fodder. So the bales are torn to pieces. So they are toning this means they are tearing this bales into pieces, and they are cleaning of dust. So they are cleaning from dust, roots, okay, and other impurities they are taking by the knives of the great machines, by the help of the knives of the machines which are bearing the peaceful name. So they are bearing the peace. Bearing means it looks like a peaceful name of willow. Willow means a tree of temperate climates that has narrow leaves which bear catkins and grows near water. These grasses then passes to a tremendous digesters or boilers. So this grass is then passes to a tremendous means very great amount, a great intensity of boilers. Boilers is a fuel which is burning apparatus which is used for heating water, whereby the action of steam and chemical is changed to wet stringy pulp. So by the action of steam, and in steam is a vapor, okay, in which the water is converted when heated, and it is forming a minute droplets in the air. Steam and chemicals, when by the action of steam and chemicals this grass is changed into a wet stringy pulp. Wet stringy. Stringy is resembling a string in being long and thin. This grass is changed into a pulp. So that